did a film in India on leprosy and found that doctors there purposely shook hands with lepers. And the film was made for an English charity called LEPRA. And the director was a chap called Richard Biggin, and his wife was our assistant, and she took care of getting the rushes away and through the customs and all that sort of thing. She could charm the customs. Usually it had to be done with bribery, but she got away with many things. Anyway, it was most interesting to see the devotion of the doctors to people who were really badly off. They were despised by their neighbors. And it started with parents hiding children who show any signs of leprosy. Nobody knows how it's transmitted. I don't think they still know it. And the main damage is done that people with leprosy lose their sense of feeling. So they touch hot pots and pans, or coal even, and burn their fingers. The nicest thing I remember was a leprosarium run by French nuns, and they gave us a French dinner in the middle of nowhere. And during the dinner, one of the nuns went into an adjoining room and came out screaming because she said, "I felt a snake around the switch." So the cook was called, and he brought the hatchet, and he killed the snake which was there. But that's how they had to work under such conditions. We met one Swiss doctor who did operations on sinews in hands of people who lost their use of the hand. And he said he comes out every year for 3 months to work in a leprosarium because he could do surgery there, which he was a general practitioner. He liked to do surgery but didn't have the qualification to do it in Switzerland. And he did very good work. So I was lucky in my life, as I said before. I had opportunities which nobody really gets in other jobs, to go into factories, to go down coal mines, to go into farms, to go into hospitals. All things which one normally doesn't do. Only I had this opportunity, and had the opportunity of taking pictures. Apropos leprosy, one of the pictures I took on that was used by the organization who had sent us for getting funds, and they used this picture many times in daily papers, and they collected £250,000 with that one picture. That was very satisfying for me and for them.